Hey guys, DVD update part two. So, by the way, this next movie is, a movie my girlfriend bought, and I'd never heard of it before, and apparently this was a movie that she used to grow up watching all the time, and it's called Troop Beverly Hills, and it's, it was alright. It's her, she's a troop leader for these Girl Scouts, and, you know, all she knows is shopping and stuff, and apparently it's like, they're like, well, you know, you're not qualified for this. And it's like her interacting with all these little girls. And one of the little girls is Carla Gugino from Sin City. So that's kind of cool. But, it's alright. I mean, she loved it. And I just, by the way, this is my girl's Turby Twisty. And I don't know why I have it on. But, why not put a little purple into my life? Next one up, $5 at Best Buy. And it's a movie that caught my eye. And it was, It's Sex and Death 101, and it stars Simon Baker from The Mentalist, and Winona Ryder, and a bunch of other chicks that you've probably seen before. Basically, he gets this email saying all these 101 girls that he slept with, but he's only slept with like the first 10. So all these other ones are like girls that he's gonna sleep with, so he's like, oh, let me see the list and go find these girls, and so forth and so forth. It's actually alright. It's the people that did Heathers, and it was just alright. I mean, for $5, thank God I didn't pay over $5, because I would have been upset. Next one, I bought this with another movie at Best Buy, and it's if you bought two, save $5. And that's what I did. And one of the first movies out of the two is The Wrestler, and I absolutely love this movie. I think it's excellent, because I kind of like wrestling, so I knew I would like the story. And Mickey Rourke is just phenomenal in this movie. I mean, he completely transformed himself into a wrestler, and he just did an amazing job, and he should have won Best Actor. I don't know why he didn't. I mean, because of this movie now, this guy's like, I saw his IMDb, he's got like 10 movies coming out within like the next year or so. So it's just like, he's having a Robert Downey Jr. moment, and I love that, because it's well deserved. And overall, it's a great movie, great performances, of course, by him. And I thought Evan Rachel Wood was just fantastic in this movie as well. She plays her daughter, and it's basically him. He's like a washed-up wrestler from the 80s, and it's just showing you like what he's going through now as a wrestler in the present. And it's just an overall fantastic, very emotional, slightly depressing movie, but it's great, and you have to check it out. Next up is the other movie that I saved $5 with, and it's Notorious. And my girlfriend really wanted to see this more than I did, but I did want to see this as well. And it's basically a biopic of the Notorious B.I.G. And I was never really big into his music. I liked I Love It When You Call Me Big Papa. That was an awesome song. But it's just the story of him, and it looks fantastic, first of all. And I was really surprised by how really touching and really well acted this movie was. I thought it was great. The guy looks exactly like Notorious B.I.G., which is insane. Overall, it's just a great movie. If you don't know his story, I would definitely suggest... I would suggest renting this, because Notorious B.I.G. is not for everybody. If you've never heard of him, I don't know how well you would connect with this movie and the story. But if you grew up listening to him, I should definitely recommend picking this one up and seeing it, because it's really great. And the girl that plays Faith, his wife... looks exactly like hers. It's crazy. But you should definitely check it out. It's really good. And I really liked it. And it comes with the digital copy. Of course it does. Every Fox movie comes with a digital copy. Next up, I really don't know why I paid the $13 I did for this movie, because everywhere I've seen it's been $20. And I wanted to see this one. I didn't really want to see when it's in the theater, but I was very curious about it, and my girlfriend wanted to see it, so I'm like, $13 at Walmart. F it. Let's just check it out. And I'm really disappointed that I spent $13. This is a $5 movie. And it's The Haunting of Molly Hartley. And this was like, this came out around the time when The Uninvited came out, The Unborn came out, and this came out. All like together in 1 month. And I think so far out of the three, this is definitely the worst. Actually, I've never seen The Unborn. But it's just, it's like, let's just get a bunch of hot CW stars and put them in a movie. Because it's just... alright. I don't even want to explain it. It's just, rent this. Do not buy this movie. Though I wondered, this girl who plays Molly Hartley, she looks very familiar, and I can't picture, or I can't put my finger on where I've seen her from, but it's got Chase Crawford from Gossip Girls, it's got Annalyn McCord from 90210, it's got some other chick that I've seen before, but overall, it's not really scary at all. There's no really freaky moments to it. It's not like Emily Rose at all. Kind of stay away from it. Just rent it. I mean, you may like it. And I don't really want to get into the story. I'm sorry for not explaining the story, whatever. It's just, it's one of those movies where, like, nothing really, it's kind of laughable. And it's just hard to explain, but just stay away from it. Next up is a movie that I remember seeing a trailer for, and I thought it was kind of looked pretty cute. And when I say cute, you probably assume it's a romantic comedy, and it is. But I saw it at Walmart in the $5 bin, and it caught my eye. And I assumed it'd probably be decent, and I really did enjoy it. And it's I Can Never Be Your Woman, and it stars Paul Rudd and Michelle Pfeiffer. And this movie is actually really, really funny. It's basically Michelle Pfeiffer who plays like a writer on this sitcom, and you know it's doing pretty well, and they're looking for this guy for this character on the show, and she runs into Paul Rudd who's trying out for the role, and he's actually a breath of fresh air for her, and you know she hires him, and it turns out like they kind of start liking each other, and then they start dating, and then it's just overall a really funny show, and apparently she's like in her 40s and he's supposed to be like 20. It's just basically like one of those older women, older men, younger couple, whatever. I really enjoyed it. It's the same people that did Clueless, and you see a lot of people from Clueless, like Paul Rudd's in it. What's her name? Stacey Dash is in this. I believe one of the teachers from Clueless is in this. That guy that was in Saved by the Bell. Really good. But I have to say, I'm really surprised by like how good Michelle Pfeiffer looks. I mean, I think she's like over 40, and she looks incredible for 40. I mean, she doesn't even, at times, like, I'm like, is she really 40? I mean, she looks great. You know, if you can look that good at her age, all the power to you. But it's really funny. It's Paul Rudd. It was just a great movie. I really enjoyed it. It was a movie I can watch over and over again. I would think you would like, if you like Clueless, you'll probably like this. And go to Walmart and get it for $5. It's really good. I promise you'll like it. And John Lovitz is in it, and Fred Willard, Tracy Ullman, great cast, really funny. And I'm really surprised by it too, and I paid $5 for it. Last one up on the thing on the DVD update is Back to the Future Part 2. And I actually got this at my local Publix, which is a supermarket. And it says $14.99, but here's what happened. Like, I go to the DVD section. I usually don't. But I saw this little thing attached to, like, the little DVD wall. And it looked like a coupon. And it said $5 off any movie between $11.99 and $14.99. So I'm like, okay. I took it off. Because I don't even know if I was supposed to take it. I took it off. And I was looking, and I saw Part 2. And Part 2 was actually my favorite part in this series. And it's pretty much, like, $15 everywhere. So I got it for $9.99. So I love the beginning when he goes to the future in 2015 and he's like riding on a hoverboard, and I'm like, it's 2009 and we don't have anything remotely close to 2015 in Back to the Future, which is quite sad. And I'm glad I got it. It doesn't have as many features as the first one, but I needed it, and I don't want Part 3, so I got the two I wanted, and I haven't watched it yet either. It's one of those, like I said, I've seen it a bunch of times, and when I get to a point where there's nothing to watch, put it on. So, that's about it for this DVD update. I hope you enjoyed it. And it looks like I might be making my DVD updates again. So, let me know if you guys want that. And if you don't want it, I won't do it anymore. So, thanks for watching. Comment, rate, subscribe, tell your friends about me. And thanks for watching. See you later.